Want to make sure you never miss a Kindly Keyin video again? Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell to turn on notifications.
If we get caught by Stan while we're holding this golden key, we have to start at the very beginning, which will be very, very upsetting for me. So I'm really, really hoping that he's not just standing outside this doorway right now. No! That was like the worst case scenario. Everybody, I am Kindly Keyin, and welcome back to Angry Neighbor. It's been a while since we've played. I miss Stan. He's everybody's favorite brother of the guy from Hello Neighbor, which, you know, boggles my mind, kinda. The guy from Hello Neighbor, we still don't actually know his name. I mean, I know that, like, FGTV or somebody named him Mart, and that kinda took off. I know, like, Jacksepticeye, he called him Wilson, Mr. Wilson, like, from Home Improvement, you know, Tim Allen, that guy who had the fence over his face. Yeah, that whole thing. But we don't actually know the name of the neighbor, which is kind of upsetting. I mean, the full game is out now, and he just doesn't have a name. But this guy, his brother, definitely has a name, and he is known as Stan. You guys know and love him as Stan, the man with many elbows, right? He got some extra elbows in the last update. He can actually move his arms now. Remember when he just used to stand straight and just, like, float at you? Oh, man, those were good times. Now he actually moves his arms and his legs, which is pretty impressive. This is a new update. You guys have told me that the game got updated. This is pre-release 2.3 build 580, so I'm excited to check it out. I haven't actually played it yet, and we're gonna look for things that are new. So let's go ahead and jump into the single player here. Whoa, okay, right off the bat, very, very different. It's a different time of year. It is winter time. It is snowy and cold. Yeah, that's actually kind of cool. They kind of changed the scenery here. Okay, so let's get back inside of our house here. Check it out. Grab the key. Equip the key. Come on. Equip the key. It's been a while since I played this game, so you'll have to bear with me as I get the controls down. Oh, okay. All right. We got some new stuff going on here. Yeah, okay. All right. We got presents and stuff laying around, and now we have a chimney. Huh. That's interesting. Fireplace and a chimney. How do we get upstairs? Do you think that we can... You think we can jump up there? I don't know. Normally there was a door there that gave us access to that upper area. Let's grab the red key. Let's see. I think that we use it on this door. So I don't know. Maybe we can still use it on the fireplace. That would not make sense at all, but I'm gonna try it. Yeah, nope. That does not work. Can we actually pick up the gifts? Can we throw gifts at Stan? I know how much Stan loves getting gifts, but we can't actually pick them up. Okay, it's a little disappointing. Let's go into our bedroom and see if anything's going on here. There's our ancient hamburger that, well, you know what? Since it's here, let's go ahead and pick it up. We can't eat it, but we can throw it at Stan, so we're gonna do that. Let's run over to Stan's house, see what's going on. Actually, let me just look around a little bit more, see if anything different is going on. We still got the weird binoculars upstairs. I'm not sure why. I mean, I don't know if we're spying on the neighbor or he's spying on us. It's just a weird situation all around. Maybe we're both weirdos and we're spying on each other. You spy on me, I'll spy on you. This is how it works. All right, it's time to cross the street and say hello to Stanley. I have missed you dearly, my friend. I did not want to do that. I did not want to throw the burger. I wanted to give him the burger, pick up the burger, equip the burger. There we go. And now we are going to throw a burger at Stan because we know that he loves him some cheeseburger. There he is. Have your burger. Oh, I missed. Oh, no. Oh, this is bad. This is very, very bad. He is walking at me like a Terminator. My goodness. You see that? He had that whole, like, robot walk going on. Shoot, man. All right, I gotta be honest with you. I didn't see anything different up to this point other than the fact that it's winter time. But let's continue searching the house. We could get, like, the secret cubes, right? But I worry that if we grab the cubes and then we get caught, we lose them. That's very upsetting. I don't like that, unless they fixed it. Okay, he's going over there. Let's go upstairs. Let's see what's going on upstairs. Anything? Do we still have the weird, like, water room? Yes. Does it sound kind of different now? It sounds like there's someone in there, honestly. I don't know. Stan's house is weird. I don't see any differences here. Let's see if we can get any kind of secrets going here. Nope, nothing going on there. Let's jump through the invisible door, assuming that it's still an invisible door. Oh, there we go. And we can get through it, but it doesn't look like there's anything over here. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything new up here. We've got the elevator shaft, which is still incomplete. Let's see if we can go around this way. If there's anything on this side of this kind of weird area, it doesn't look like it. Still looks very much incomplete. So there's still work to be done here in the upstairs area. Let's go back downstairs. And I don't know. I mean, do I want to get the magical cubes? I could grab the green cube. Oh, okay. All right. Stan probably knew that we were upstairs the whole time. He was just waiting for us to come downstairs so they could beat us up, send us back home. I am running out of battery. That's not good. Okay. Disaster averted. I've plugged in my tablet, although now I've got like a billion cables like wrapped around my legs like an anaconda trying to strangle me. It's not a great feeling. It's not a great situation. Let's just continue on here. Okay. So I'm digging the wintertime theme that's going on here. I like it. It's cold. It's frigid. We need to put our sweaters on. But I'm not seeing anything new quite yet. Stan still seems to be the same model and have the same movement that he did before. He seems to still have extra elbows, which is just incredibly disturbing. I don't know if the fact that he used to not move at all was more disturbing than the fact that now he moves with extra elbows. I don't know. It's all disturbing. He's just a disturbing person. We decided that he went and had some very serious surgery, some very complicated surgery to get those extra elbows installed. And now he is like half cyborg, basically. He's a robot. Stan the Android Man. There he is, staring at the window, pondering existence and what it actually means to be a human. He's a deep thinker. All right, let's go upstairs and let's see if anything's going on up there. Let's grab a box. We need two boxes, actually, and we're gonna try the very tricky path here of getting upstairs. What's there? Wait a second. Was there always a window here? Could we always just see into his bedroom? I don't think there was always a window here. Or I'm just very, very confused. Strong possibility. That is actually a strong possibility. What is going on here? Wait a second. What is that? Is that blood? Stan? What's going on here? Why is there red in your window? Oh, you know what? I think that might actually be the curtains that are... Yeah, it's the curtains. I thought it was blood. Of course not. Stan may be an android, but he's not a killer. And I'm a firm believer in that because all the times that he's caught us, we've come back. We're not dead. He just knocks us out, sends us home. He's not such a bad guy after all. He just likes chasing us around. Okay, let's go upstairs. Let's see if we can get this figured out. Let's try. Oh, this is not, that's not good placement for that box. Oh gosh. Okay. You know what? I should probably redo this. Let's get this box lined up. And yeah, that works. Okay, now let's grab this box. It's been a very long time since I've done this. So, like I said, you guys gotta bear with me as I get back up to the very top. There's some tricky jumps here, particularly this one at the top of the rope. Let's see if we can pull it off on our first try. Let's get myself situated and then back up just a little bit. Back up a little bit more. Just a little bit. Okay, that should be good. And then go for it. Oh, yes. We've done it. You know what they say? It's just like riding a bicycle. You never lose that skill of jumping from a telephone pole wire, I guess it would be electrical wire, to someone's roof. Once you've learned how to do that, you will never forget how to do it again. Sort of. This is a bad phrase. It just rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? All right, let's go up here. There's a present up here. This is nice. Is this for me? Did Stan leave this up here for me? Can I actually pick it up? Oh, I can pick it up. Oh, look at that. It's the RGB cube. Is it the blue one? It's the blue one. So it's the one that you can like launch across the stinking level. Look at that. So I wonder if the other blue one is gone now. Actually, I think that the blue one is normally, I think it's over here normally. And oh yeah, it's just sitting there. Well, that's kind of weird. I guess we can leave that one there. And if we do lose this one, we can always go back and get the blue one that is in this room. So that's kind of cool. Now we have two blue cubes. I wonder if there's a green and red present that have the green and red cubes in them. I think we're going to have to do some searching here. Now that we have the blue cube, we could probably use it to like stack up to different areas, but notably we want to get the green cube because the green cube basically allows us to fly, which is incredible. I'm just going to try something here real quick. I want to see if I can stack the blue cubes to get back onto the roof. It's obviously not the greatest method because the green cube is way better for stacking and getting up to high places, but I just want to see if we can... Wait for it. This is not working. I think we're almost... Oh, come on. No, don't fall. We can do this. Check this out. Here we go. Yes! Look at that! We got back onto the roof. Okay. Yeah. The blue cube, hey, not as useless as you might think. All right, so I missed the drop to the green cube. We were supposed to land on that 2x4 right there, and I completely missed it. But what I want to try to do is use this corner to stack up a bunch of blue cubes, and let's just see if we can make ourselves a terrible pile of blue cubes that will get us up to the green cube. That would be awesome. It kind of is working. Look at this mess. It's terrible. I feel bad for Stan. He's gonna have to clean it up later because I'm certainly not cleaning it up, but look at that. Oh my gosh. I just hit my mic because I was so excited that actually worked. So the green cube should be behind the couch. There it is. It's so beautiful. I love this thing. And now we can use this thing to get to the very top of his house, and let's see if there's anything hiding up there. Okay, yeah, I think I just realized that I was losing my mind. I think that window looking into his room was always there. I was getting confused with this door, this window right over here. This room is quite mysterious because it has no doors. It only has a window and it has one like side table in it. Very, very strange room. All right, so let's use our magical green cube powers here and get to the very, very top of Stan's house. And let's see if there's anything hiding up there. Whoa. I didn't realize that we could do that. We kind of like launched up like 30 feet in an instant. That was pretty cool. Okay, I think we're at the point where we can jump across. So let's see if we can... Oh my gosh, all right. That was actually a pretty scary jump there. I wasn't sure if we were going to make it, but we did. Is there anything going on in here? It doesn't really look like it. This looks the same as the previous update. All I'm seeing is snow, to be honest with you. And of course, a few presents littering the landscape. But otherwise, I'm not sure if this update is as big as we might have hoped for. Oh my gosh, that's so crazy. I am a little disappointed that there isn't actually more content. But you know what? Actually, one of the things that we haven't done yet is tried going to the basement. We have to go to the basement. That is the end-all be-all. Up to this point, the basement has always led to just a brick wall. Just a brick wall of disappointment. So let's see if more has been added to the actual basement of Stan's house here. Let's drop down. What a mess. So many blue cubes all over the place. It's beautiful. I love it. I love the contrast of colors. And actually what we can do here in our own house is try... Yeah, okay, so the red cube is still over here. Can I... Oh, that is not what I wanted to do. I just wanted to break the window. Can I break the window? I can't break that window. That window is unbreakable. So how are we supposed to get to the red cube? I would love to find out how to get to the red cube. Maybe we can just like phase through the ceiling here. Let's try. This is a terrible idea. I'm gonna break the game. Okay, I'm not gonna do that anymore. What I am gonna try to do is just go through the glass. Let's see if we can just, maybe we can, nope, can't get through the glass. Maybe we can break it with something different. Maybe we can use like this jug of water to break the glass. There you go. Okay, so that actually worked. I do have a slight issue though, and that I've put too many of these green cubes in the way. There's too many of them. Oh gosh, what have I done? What am I doing? Okay, there we go. And then can I? Yeah, okay, there we go. We got it. There, we got the red cube, we found it. So now we have all the cubes in our inventory. Can we actually pick up these gifts? We can.
And it's more blue cubes? What?
Wait a second. Can I actually pick up the gifts that are in my living room? Maybe I was just pressing the wrong button? No, I can't pick up that gift. Okay. So, the blue gift boxes are apparently the blue cube. So there's tons of blue cubes just laying around this map right now. Which is pretty cool because if you lose them, you can go back and pick up a different one. Okay, so we have the superpower of the cubes with us right now. I'm hoping that we can use them to try and get to the basement as quickly and effectively as possible. If we do get caught by Stan, unfortunately we are, at least I'm gonna assume that we're gonna lose all the cubes that are in our inventory right now, so that'll be very sad if that does happen. I wouldn't be too surprised if it does end up happening because Stan, he's a wily guy and he's always after us. I think he might actually be upstairs right now. I don't think he goes upstairs though. Maybe I can like block him in with some blue cubes if he's upstairs. He's not upstairs. He's not upstairs. Get out of there. No, please. Please don't. Please stop. Please stop chasing me. Is he gonna chase me all the way to my house? Okay, no, he's not. He stops now. He used to just continue chasing you all the way to your bedroom. It was a nightmare. All right, let's sneak around the side here. I'm not sure exactly. Well, we can turn on the TV. That's probably what we want to do. And then get the silver key so that we can access. That is not what I wanted to do. So that we can access the sledgehammer, which is in the closet just around the corner. Oh, goodness. Okay, don't want to mess around with that. Let's get this going here. Open up that. Oh, no. No. Run, get away. Did you notice that there's presents on top of the cars that are driving down the street? That seems very dangerous. You should take those off of your hood. Here, have some blue cubes. I insist. There you go. Have those. They're fun. Stan apparently is not a fan of our blue cubes. What a party pooper. Okay, so we need to get to Stan's bedroom and grab the key that is being held by the mannequin. Yes, right over there. Okay, so we need to get in there. We can't use the blue cubes to break windows, as we have learned, but we can use just regular boxes to break windows. Let's go ahead and do that. That was a terrible throw. Try that again. Here we go. Bam. There we go. All right. So hopefully, I don't know if he responds to his glass being broken like the neighbor does. I think I saw him. Yeah, nah, he doesn't seem to really care. He's okay with it. He must have some great, like, homeowner's insurance that just covers any kind of glass breakage from children coming over to your house and throwing boxes at your windows. Okay, let's grab the key right there. Equip it. I think that he is in the hallway right now, just to our right. I'm not actually sure. No, this is so bad. This, oh my gosh. Oh, that was so, so bad. We had the key. That is the worst time to get caught because it's all gone now. We have to start over. Oh, man. All right, so here we are back at the beginning of the game. Very, very frustrating that if you're holding an item, I've complained about this many times in the past, but if you're holding an item in the game and you get caught by Stan, it disappears from the game. So we lost the silver key. It's gone forever. So we basically had to restart our game to get it back. That is a very, very frustrating bug that the developers have to fix before this game is completed because that is super, super annoying. Okay, I have the silver key. Now I just need to take it over to the... Oh! Stan was right there. Is he still there? Yes, he is. Please don't turn this direction, Stan. Please. Yes. Yes. Continue into the living room. Perfect. That's what I'm talking about. Get this thing open. Okay, so we don't need the silver key anymore. We don't have to worry about that too much. We can grab the sledgehammer, which we need to break down the slats that are on the basement door. Oh. 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 Okay. All right. Good. Good. Great. That's fantastic. Let's use this here. And now we don't need the sledgehammer anymore. All we need is the golden key, which is in the room right over there. The one with the giant metal plate in front of it. Oh, Stan Sauce. No. Yeah, he's chasing us. Oh my gosh, that weird robot Terminator. All right, so we got this switch. Now we have to get the other switch at the end of the hallway, but I think Stan is over there. Yep. There he was. Okay. That is fantastic. Let's see if he's still... Okay, he went the other direction, so we should be able to hit the switch. And now we should be able to get into the gold key room. Of course, we have to platform our way to the very top. Let's grab some boxes. We're gonna need these. Let's just grab a couple of these. And I don't know where he is right now, so I'm just gonna sneak my way in here, close the door behind me. Hopefully he didn't notice us. Let's go ahead and equip these boxes and get our golden key, and then we can get access to the basement, and we'll see if anything has changed in that regard. All right, we made it to the top. We got our golden key. Now, of course, this is kind of a tricky situation because we've made all this progress, and if we get caught by Stan while we're holding this golden key, we have to start at the very beginning, which will be very, very upsetting for me. So I'm really, really hoping that he's not just standing outside this doorway right now. No! That was like the worst case scenario. The absolute worst case scenario. He was literally standing outside the door just waiting for us to come out and beat us over the head and take our golden key and make us restart the entire game. All right, so we started over. I'm making my way back through, but I just noticed something kind of terrifying about Stan. Apparently, when he's chasing you, if you run through a door, he will literally destroy the door. As you can see, his front door here is, well, it disappeared now, but it was just laying there. He just blasted through it. He destroyed it with his Terminator arms. So yeah, I just thought I'd share that with you guys while I make my way through this very, very troubling sequence of events here. I'm really having a hard time getting to the basement, and Stan is not making it easy on me. He's right behind me. Yeah, there you go. Okay, I finally got the golden key. Now I just need to get out of this room again, and I have no idea where Stan is. If he's here again, I'm gonna be so mad. Oh, he's chasing me. He's chasing me. Get the heck out of here. Just get out of here. Okay, we made it out of his house with the gold key. So now I just need to wait for him to get back into his patrol routine, and then we can open up the door. However, I haven't gotten the sledgehammer yet, so I still need to get the sledgehammer and knock all the 2x4s off of the basement door. But once I do that, we're going in. All right, here we go. Here's our chance. I can't. Oh my gosh. I can't remove it without removing the slats first. Oh my goodness. Okay, so now this kind of changes the whole situation quite a bit because I have to grab the sledgehammer while holding the golden key. And can I put the golden key down? No, I can't put it down. There's nothing I can do. So we learned a very valuable lesson today. We should always get the sledgehammer first and knock the slats off of that door. Otherwise, you're gonna get in the situation that I'm in right now, and it's not a great feeling. I did open the door that has the sledgehammer in it, but I didn't actually grab the sledgehammer because Stan ended up catching me, and it ended up ruining all my plans. Okay, now he's chasing us again. That's fun. Okay, I think he's right around the corner here, but this is our chance. This is our break. Let's grab the sledgehammer, get out of there, equip the sledgehammer, please. Oh my gosh, okay. Knock these stupid things off, equip the golden key, remove the stupid lock, and get in. And there's nothing there. There's nothing there again. Wait a second, there's a present in our inventory that we could actually pick up. What the, what? Okay. We can plant a tree. Is that my reward for getting to the basement? Okay. Yeah, I gotta be real with you guys. I was hoping for a little bit more when I found out that there's an update for this game. I'm a little disappointed that there wasn't more to it, but I guess they're just kind of doing like a winter theme thing here. I really hope that there's a bigger update coming that actually adds new content. We still have not seen what's inside of the basement. I don't know if they have an intention on actually adding a proper basement. The upper floors are still completely empty. There's not a lot going on there. I love the cubes. They added the cubes in a recent update, but I'd love to see more crazy secrets and stuff like that. It would be a lot of fun to get some actual more content. I enjoyed the winter thing going on, the cold is cool, but come on, let's get some more content going here. But anyways, guys, hopefully you still enjoyed this. We did get to explore a little bit more of Angry Neighbor, and we got to see Stan once again, and it's been a while since we saw him. If you did enjoy this, be sure to hit that like button, and of course, if you'd like to see more, you can subscribe to my channel by clicking on that little circle with my logo in it right below this window. You can also watch more of my videos by clicking on the sides of the screen. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.